what if they start a religious sect based on the getting the date wrong?
Yes.
Well, of course. It's always going to... I mean, Harold Camping is old as dirt. I mean, you know, he could go any minute. So the fact that he would be gone wouldn't be a surprise.
Right.
But, you know, I mean, the followers. I mean, this one woman that's driving around in her car. Allison, I can't remember her last name. But, you know, she is absolutely certain that this is going to happen. And she's looking forward to it. And
she's going to be taken.
That's what she believes, yes. Yes. You know, there's only a certain percentage of chosen people, and nobody knows who that is. And I haven't.
It was like getting a Wonka ticket? Like.
Yeah. It's like the lottery, I guess. But, you know, there's a small percentage of people, and I have not read an exact time.
What do you think your odds are better at, winning the lottery or being one of the rapture?
I hope it's the lottery because, you know, I plan on sticking around. I'm not going anywhere.
Yeah, I actually do not want to be raptured. I love my life down here, and I want to stay down here and enjoy it as much as possible. I want to revel in it. I got shit I want to do. Mm-hmm. So don't take me away. I've got a lot of plans for the rest of the year.
We got a party and a concert. Please, not now.
Right.
Exactly.
I mean, I think we all, even the people who believe it's going to happen, know at some point, this is crap. I mean, besides that lady, which she probably actually believes it, most of the people, it's crap. You know it is. You know it in your heart. You know that this is not going to happen. Whether you know that there's a God, you'll be able to rationalize it away. However, you'll just be able to rationalize it away. But you know this event where people get taken, just flash a light, boom, they're gone. Mm-hmm. I mean, this isn't those cheesy apocalypse revelations movies.
No,
you ever watch those movies with like Mr. T? And it's got like Casper Van Dien in it,
and
it's like the end of the world, and you know it's God, but you never see God, but you always see the devil, and he's got wings, and he's, you know, winging. It's like, come on, dude, like this is so lame.
This Straight is to like video the classics.
Yeah, it's like airy. I don't know. I'm much more entertained by even things I don't like Lord of the Rings and Harry Potter. Even though I'm much more of a Trekkie and a sci-fi dude, I would be much more entertained by that and give that much more credibility than anything religion is selling. Anything.
Yeah, amen to that. Now, you have, since we've been discussing this over in North Carolina, it's become actually very apparent that you have a strong following over here on the East Coast. So I'd imagine that, you know, if you're aware of that, you've been wanting to come to the East Coast for quite some time.
I have.
Certainly the East Coast has been wanting you to come to the East Coast for quite some time.
I have been. I mean, the thing is, my fans are great, but there's something unique about my fans that I love. And it comes from a troll message that I got on YouTube a couple days ago. And then the troll basically said something to the account of, why would you alienate non-atheists? And basically, why would you alienate people who don't think like you, for the most part? And I thought about it. There's so many ways I could have answered this question. And I don't think of it as ways as I'm alienating, but I feel like I'm qualifying people for my music. There is a certain intelligence level that is required. Not to say that I'm a genius or anything, but, you know, you have to understand certain things if you're even going to enjoy the music. You can listen to it, of course, but for you to really enjoy it, like I think a lot of the fans, like my fans do, my followers do, these are smart people. Like, my fans are brilliant, far smarter than I am. And it's crazy because I get, you know, physicists, yo, man, I love that dude, and, you know, biologists and doctors, and, you know, I want to see how many, you know, I want to see how many doctors are Lil Wayne fans, or, you know, I mean, I'm being honest. I'm not, nothing about his music, but I want to know if they relate to the context of his music, and if they can relate to the context and the subject matter of my music, why? It's got to be education. Not to say that I'm that much more educated than anybody else, but I think that my fans tend to be more generally informed about how the world works, you know, the religions and how they operate, political structures, whether we all agree on political systems or not is a completely different issue. We're pretty well informed about the different political positions that are out there. My fans are generally smart people. So for me, if you actually are interested in my music and you're one of those people, I want to be where you are. I don't care if it's just 12 of y'all. I'll come to your house and perform in your backyard. I don't care. You know, we'll tear it up that night and we'll just do it up because my fans are dope like that.
That sounds like a plan.
I would hate to have a dumb ass fan. Could you imagine coming to my show and these jackasses show up and have no intention of contributing to the vibe? They just want to sit in a club and look at everybody else hard for no damn reason. And I disown these dudes like, man, these dudes came to see my music. Man, that sucks, man. I don't know these dudes. I don't want these dudes. No. Man, I want to see the physicist that came down from university. I want to see the guy who's, you know, on his master's program who comes out to see Greydon Square. Why? Because that's what those guys listen to.
That's awesome.
I want to be that guy for them. I want to serve a different purpose in hip-hop. I don't want the Lil Wayne fans. I don't want the Royce fans. I don't want the Bieber fans. That's not success for me. How many records I sell is not success for me. How many people show up to my concert is not success for me. It's who shows up to my concert. If Neil deGrasse Tyson can say, yo, Greydon is dope, that's all I care about. I don't care what mainstream hip hop thinks about Greydon Square or what he thinks about religion. I could care less if you think I'm alienating those people. I don't want those people listening to my music. There's a reason why I don't sign to a label. There's a reason why I've turned down labels. I don't want that. I want the brainiac. I want the nerd. I want the geek. That's
what I like that.
We're going to have a no jackass clause on our tickets.
I'm serious. And I mean, you know, you don't even have to, and it's not even something that you could look at like visually and say, okay, he's a jackass. I don't know. But
here's the mark of the jackass.
People out there genuinely just carry a destructive nature about them.
Right. And they have negative, incurious, unthinking, and downright mean in many cases people. Yeah, right. I don't like being around them either, yeah.
And I'm just saying that I don't want those people really, if my music goes over your head, it probably wasn't meant for you. That's all I'm trying to say.
Gotcha. So what can we expect, particularly on the Sunday, for someone who's new to all this, doesn't understand hip-hop culture particularly, but is very interested in your work, what can they expect when they walk through the door on the Sunday to see you in concert?
All right, so there's a fundamental difference between listening to someone and coming to see them perform, because there's something much more intimate about a live performance. And what I mean is, my music, the way I write my music in the form of arguments, challenges, contests to positions. When I'm performing in front of you, I'm challenging you. I'm challenging your inner theist. And I'm challenging the guy next to you who may be a theist. And I'm challenging the guy next to him who came in here and said, hey, I'm a theist, but I came to your show anyway. There's something about being next to you and looking in your eyes, spitting lyrics. Like, it's me and you talking about this. We're having a conversation, lyrically. And I'm just explaining to you how I feel about their positions and how they feel about me. And I think when you come to a Greydon Square show, and I lay out my arguments and I lay out my positions in the way that I do it first of all to honor hip hop, because this is the culture that I represent. This is the culture that I defend, even though I don't agree with all of it. And, you know, we've definitely taken a lot of hits in recent years about our credibility and who we market to, but I'm hip hop, and you come to see a manifestation of hip hop in the universe. That's what you come to see. And I want to explain and explore that universe, cover that universe, talk about the facts in it, not the myths, not the stuff that people make up. So
see,
I just hope
I'm inspired. People, I can't wait.
I just hope that when people come to a Greydon Square show, you know, they leave better and more informed than when they got there. The same way I want you for a Greydon Square song or a Greydon Square album. I want you to leave with more information than you had before you got there. Yo, I heard on this Greydon Square CD, he was talking about, you know, crazy stuff. I got to go look this stuff up. Transfinite numbers. What's a transfinite number? Whoa. and you go Google, and then you, when you Google transfinite number, you see very large number, and then you stumble on the Graham's number, and then now you're getting in touch with the fact that you really liked math growing up, but you had to lie because you were around dumb niggas who didn't like math. So for me, though, these are the type of people, like, that inspires me to speak to those type of people.